So this was answered wrong again. So this was not answered by me two times wrong. This is, we tend to change on this site, so on that site. Allah. Okay, I will tell everything here, I think. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. Professor Levin did have some bad ideas about similar things, and he knows almost everything in physics. So we are humans, we make mistakes. Not me here. So a complete series circuit consists of 12.5 volt battery, 4.68 resistor, and switch. The internal resistance of the battery is 0.360 ohms. And there is a questions F1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 part of the questions. What does an ideal voltmeter read when placed across the terminals of the battery? Switch is open. When there is no current throughout the circuit and switch is open, terminal will show us exactly what the battery is. That is 12.5 volts. Part B. What does an ideal voltmeter read when it plays across the resistor? The switch is open. When there is no current throughout the resistor and you place the voltmeter, there is absolutely no volts. Why? If there was any, there would be a current, but there is no current. So there is a 0 volts. Part C. What does an ideal voltmeter read when placed across the switch? The switch is open. So ideal voltmeter does not conduct any kind of electricity through it. So there is no current throughout ideal voltmeter. And in that case, that voltage is the same as the voltage of the battery, because there is no current, and that is what it is. Part D. What does an ideal voltmeter read when placed across the terminals of the battery? The switch is closed. So, what is happening now? Now there is a current throughout the system. We will just calculate what is that current. First. You didn't see that. Just for play. So, first we need the current. So that is, current is voltage source divided by resistance. The resistance in this part is internal resistance plus that resistance in ohms. So that is 12 volts, and this is the resistance of the source, and this is the resistance of the resistor. And we did find current of 2.48 amperes that goes around here. That is the current, definitely. Now, for part D, what is the question? What does an ideal voltmeter read across places? Across the terminals of the battery. Now, what does the ideal voltmeter read when placed across the resistor? So, pay attention here, there's the same voltage. Why? Because that is the same thing. This thing here is that part D. When the switch is closed, current moves, then the question, what is reading here? Well, reading here is the same as reading here. So we could take this one, this point to be here, and this 2 points to be here. So it will be absolutely same. Resistor here, voltage here, and voltage here when the current is moving along. It's the same thing. There is absolutely no difference there. Need a little bit thinking out of the box, so to speak. So we did first have to find the voltage, that is same as here, but we needed current and Ohm's law. We cannot apply Ohm's law for the part of the circuit on the source, but we can apply it on these resistors here. So we apply voltage, Ohm's law for the part of the circuit on this resistor here, and there is absolutely same voltage between those 2 points and those 2 points here, because these 2 points are the same voltage and these 2 points are same voltage. Almost identical. Not completely identical, but in reality, but when we calculate, it's almost the same, because there is almost no resistance in these wires here. So it doesn't matter. So this is the part voltage across these two points, and that is absolutely the same as here. And that is the answer under part D and under part E. And part F, what does an ideal voltmeter read when placed across the switch? The switch is closed. So there is a 0 volt across the switch. And why is there 0 volts across the switch? Well, switch is conductor. And when you close conductor, and there is a current, there has to be, of course, voltage difference there. But that voltage difference is very, very small for that current to move, because there is almost no resistance in the wires. And that's why bird is not killed when it puts its two little feet on the bare wires on that long range transporter, of current, what do you call that, between two large posts, between cities. Current goes in the naked wires, and birds stands like this, and the current and did not get killed. Why is that? Well, because the voltage difference between those two plates, these two plates, yeah, is small. So it is what it is. There is absolutely nothing more in the PDF file except this, what I already told you. But if you want to donate, you can. For complete written answer, please follow the link in the description. If you want more of this, please subscribe and tell your friends. Do you want me to tell again? No, no need. Okay, bye.